the past is always present. We look at this black and white film footage and somehow we think it's ancient history, but it's not.
Jeremy Dean got his start as a professional artist with the 2006 documentary Dare Not Walk Alone, which documented, for the first time, St. Augustine's bloody and contentious civil rights era. The film used archival video to tell the city's history and contemporary interviews to show its through line.
When I would show the film early on, pretty much universally, people would look at that footage, and particularly white people would say, well, that's evil, that's wrong, that's immoral, but thank goodness that's not who we are anymore. Fast forward to 2020, when they tried to remove the Confederate monument, guess what happened? Same thing. White supremacists, Klan members, Proud Boys, Oath Keepers came from all across the country to St. Augustine. They were waving Don't Tread on Me flags, Confederate flags, spewing vitriol, spewing hate. And in a split screen image of those two events, 1964 and 2020, it looks exactly the same.
Some observers were surprised by the hostility on display in St. Augustine this summer, but Dean sees it as consistent with the city's history.
I interviewed civil rights activists from all across the country that came to St. Augustine, and they were in Selma, they were in Birmingham, they were in some of the hot spots across the South during the civil rights movement. And to a person, they all said that the scaredest place they ever were in all the civil rights movement was St. Augustine, Florida. Where they feared for their life most was in St. Augustine, even compared to Edmund Pettus Bridge, water hoses. St. Augustine was much more dangerous. And I think the same thing was borne out this summer. I think that people literally feared for their life this summer. As a matter of fact, some of these guys beat the contractor who was in charge of moving the monument. They beat him with American flags. And so the threat for violence was very real.
In 2010, Dean's most high-profile project, part sculpture, part performance art, converted a Hummer into a horse-drawn stagecoach, which he drove through Central Park. Now, Dean is back in Florida with an exhibit that returns his focus to Northeast Florida's not-so-distant past and not-so-different present.
At this show, you'll see stereo-view photographs, which are some of the earliest known images of African-Americans in Northeast Florida. And those are placed on pieces of the Confederate monument that was recently removed in St. Augustine, these foundational elements from the monument. Symbols do matter. Symbols are important. The monument has to be dealt with. However, I also think that if all we do is move the symbol and we don't deal with the foundation, we don't deal with the structure that supports the symbol, we run the risk of doing something symbolic. So for me, it was really important to unearth this unseen structural foundation as a poetic way to talk about systemic issues and structural racism.
The name of Dean's new exhibit at the Museum of Contemporary Art Jacksonville is Neither I Nor Time Nor History.
There's been a quote by James Baldwin that has been sort of my guiding light for the last 10 years, and where the title of the show comes from. And James Baldwin said, "This is the crime of which I accuse my country and my countrymen, and for which neither I nor time nor history will ever forgive them. That they have destroyed and are destroying hundreds of thousands of lives and do not know it and do not want to know it. It's their innocence that constitutes the crime." And for me, that's been really illuminating because I think for so many of us in the white community in America, we think, well, you know, I didn't own slaves. I'm not a racist. We think racism are the people waving Confederate flags, you know, with KKK hoods. And I think what James Baldwin is saying is that we have inherited an America that was built on a system that benefits white privilege, white class, and has denied those same privileges to others. So what James Baldwin was trying to do was point out the connection between innocence and ignorance. And that's what all the work that I'm trying to do now is about, is trying to collapse the space between ignorance and innocence and say that really there is no innocence. We collectively, as a country, bear responsibility for what whiteness has cost other people. You know, racism is not a problem just for Black people. It's an American problem. And white people created it. And so white people have to be the ones responsible for changing it.
He's less idealistic than he was 20 years ago, when he hoped his documentary would bring about immediate change. But Dean does believe art fosters incremental, consequential, and ultimately long-lasting change.
Art can help change culture. And then once culture starts to change, then society follows. As often been said, you know, the civil rights generation's job was to change laws, and our generation's job is to change hearts and minds. And so I think that that's very much the role that art and culture can play, is to change hearts and minds, to have big paradigm shifts. that can be revolutionary.
Neither I, nor time, nor history is at the Museum of Contemporary Art Jacksonville through May 16th. Anne Schindler, First Coast News, on your side.